Hey girls and boys, it's Jordan, back at it again with another YouTube video. So you know how, not in my last video, but the one before that, I said about how I really want to start doing more one brow and makeup looks. I do a lot of clothing, so I want to do now a lot of makeup. And guess what? That is exactly what I am doing today. Now, because I am completely transparent with you guys about working with brands, of course. I mean, why would I not be? Like, I pick and choose the brands I work with wisely. Like, I don't just take anything. And I'm legit proud to sit here and talk about this brand or products. I just really believe in them. So, yeah. Just so you guys know, today's video is in collab with Cult Beauty, which is so exciting because Cult Beauty has actually been one of my favorite websites for the longest time now. Like, anytime I want, you know, more American-based makeup, I guess, or just the more harder brands to get hold of, they stock them, so it's so good. So yeah, Cult Beauty have challenged me to do a one brand and makeup look, and that brand is gonna be Too Faced. Now, I've used a few things from Too Faced, like it's not a new brand to me, but there is a lot of stuff that I've not tried, so I'm excited. So you might be wondering why I'm doing Too Faced out of all brands. It is because Too Faced is Cult Beauty's brand of the month at the moment. Too Faced is doing well. It's also Cult Beauty's 10th anniversary, and to celebrate they have discounts and free gifts and stuff, and I'm about to tell you guys because I know you will appreciate it. This part's for you guys, like this is for you. Anytime that I can get you guys a little bit of money off so you can save your coins, you know I will. I'll make this really, really quick so that I don't bore you with my voice for the next hour. So because Too Faced is the brand of the month, they have free shipping for the month of June, which is so cool, so you know you can save a little bit of money there. Another little thing, if you spend over, I think it's £40 on Too Faced, was it 40? Can I keep this stuff in my memory? You get a free, where are you? No. You get a free deluxe size of the Hangover RX Primer. This is the full version, so it'll be a little bit smaller than this, but yeah, still a deluxe size, like, I'll take it. And then also because it's Cult Beauty's 10th anniversary, they're doing like a bunch of like cool things like discounts and free gifts and new product launches and just loads of cool stuff. To know more about like what you will actually get and all the offers and everything, make sure you head over to the Cult Beauty website because they have all the deets there. I kind of only know so much, so. And then the little bit which I'm just like, so cute. Cult Beauty has super, super kindly given me an exclusive discount code to give to you guys, my followers. That just melts my heart. So if you spend over £50, yeah, which seems like a lot, but you can get something really cool from it. So at the checkout, if you enter the discount code JORDAN10BDAY, I will leave it on the screen now. What you will get in your order is this little cute card here. Basically, this will give you £10 off your next order and you need no minimum spend. So meaning that you can spend £10 and basically get your order for free. Basically a £10 gift card. How cool is that? So yeah, this is a little gift from me and Cult Beauty to you guys. So yeah. I hope you enjoy. This is another reason as well why I love Cult Beauty and really wanted to work with them is they genuinely care about my followers and want to do things to include you guys and save you money, etc. And I love that. That's like so important to me. So yeah, guys, happy shopping. Anyway, right, let's get into this Too Faced testing video. I may or may not have it on my face right now. Who knows? So yeah, if you want to see my thoughts on a bunch of Too Faced makeup and maybe to see what you could spend on Too Faced on Cult Beauty, then just keep watching. Hey, what are you doing? Just gonna like tuck him back in there. Thank you very much. I don't even really know where to start. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and do brows first, even though low-key, I freaking hate doing my brows first. I hate having to be like really careful and like going around them. Like I have two different types of brow products here because honestly, I kind of couldn't choose. I mean, normally I'm a pencil girl, but I got like both types just so we can see, we can test. It's what I'm here to do. So I have their brow pencil, which is called the Chocolate Brownie. It's called the Cocoa Powder Brow Pencil. It's 12-hour wear, apparently. Ooh, it's waterproof. And then I also got the brow kind of like pomade. This is their Bulletproof Brows, 24-hour waterproof cashmere clay. And bulletproof brow brush. Oh my god, you get a brush? Oh my god, what the hell? Not even gonna lie, that is a pretty decent brush as well. Yeah, spoolie and an angled end. You know, like some products, you get a brow brush and it's literally like this small and you're kind of like, what the hell am I gonna do with that? Whereas this is a good size. Because size does matter. I'm joking. I think what I'm gonna do is use the brow pomade on like the end of my brow and then the brow pencil at the front of my brows just to kind of get that more gradient. Right, let's do this. Let's get some brows on my face. So I'm gonna kind of draw a line underneath my brow and then on top just to create the shape and then kind of fill it in as I go along. By the way, this pomade is in the color Universal Brunette. It's actually a really, really nice color. Like this is the typical brow color that I would go for. It's completely cool, like no warm tones at all. It's creamy at first and then it just like completely dries down. Like that is dried down. I do not feel like that is gonna come off. like at all. Like that brow's on there for the next year. I'm not normally a pomade kind of gal. But as far as I go, that's a good one. I hate it. Like it's a freaking pet peeve of mine when pomades are like hella dry and like crusty. Whereas this one really isn't when you're working with it. Now to try the pencil. What color is this little guy in? Deep brown. Okay, so you get a nice little spoolie on one end and then on the other. Oh, that's like a really interesting tip. It's like a little rectangle, but it's kind of like angled into a point. Oh my god, that's gonna be so good for the front of your brow. I can just tell. Little hair strokes. You have got to be kidding me. I was whiffing this in front of my face and I like low-key smelled chocolate and I was like, there is no way that this can smell like chocolate. Two-faced hands. That is full-on chocolate. Let me just like beauty guru you a second. Like genuinely look at this tip. Like look how fine that is. I'm gonna draw a line underneath and a line on top. Oh, she pigmented. And then just kind of like flick up. Why was that the easiest thing I've ever used in my entire existence on this earth? Let's see if I can do little brow strokes. Oh my god. Like what? How was that easy to do that? Like you have... On a real note though, I don't think I've ever used a pencil that's filled in my brow as like that gradient and then been able to add really, really thin brow strokes as well. I love everything, the color, the formula, the shape. Like this is so different and I love that. If I had to pick one between the pencil and the pomade, definitely the pencil. Right, now that this brow is done, I'm gonna go ahead and do the other one because she gotta work for it. And then I'll be back and we can carry on with the face. Okay, so brows are... Brows are on and probably looking the best I can actually get them right now. I mean, they're pretty bold right now. They're kind of like a bit in your face. But I have to say, these Too Faced brow products, what the hell? Like, I genuinely feel like these have been slept on. I've not heard anyone speak about them and I don't really know why. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do skin now. So for primer, I'm going to take the Hangover RX Replenishing Face Primer. I've used this little guy before on my channel. I do really, really like this primer. I feel like this is the kind of primer that would be so good for more like drier skin because it's a super hydrating primer. It's kind of like that moisturizing type primer, if you know what I mean. I mean, I have oily skin and I still use it. Like it doesn't affect anything like that, but I'm just saying for dry skin, you are gonna love this. And on top of that, it smells beautiful. Kind of smells like coconuts, like a beach. Like a beach. I meant to say it reminds me of being on a beach, not smells like a beach. And it actually gives you a tacky base, so your foundation will have something to stick to. Foundation now. Okay. For the 2 years that I've been doing YouTube, okay, I have never used the Born This Way foundation. When this foundation came out, this was so raved about, and even to this day, I know this is like several people's favorite go-to foundation. Now, if there's one thing I love to do is try out new foundations to find that perfect one for my skin. Now, I have oily AF skin, so finding a foundation that actually wants to stay on my face and not melt on the ground is a bit of a task, I'm not gonna lie. So, I'm excited to try this one out and see if it maybe it can be in my like top three, who knows. It says undetectable medium to full coverage foundation. It's luminous, it's oil free. I'm gonna use a booty blender, but a real booty blender this time. Brand new as well. Is that not just the most satisfying thing you've ever seen? Guys, you girls prepped. I've already run this under the tap, like honestly. Beauty blenders in the UK are not actually the easiest thing to get hold of. Like we can't just walk into a store and get one, but Cult Beauty stocks them, which is fab. Let's do it, let's just go in. This is the color Warm Beige and I actually think I picked pretty well. Wow, that coverage is so nice. I definitely see what they mean by medium because I can still see bits peeking through, but I guess if I just put on a teeny bit more, yeah, you can literally get to a full. Do you know the only thing I don't really like about the Real Beauty blenders I've noticed compared to other sponges? It blends out my foundation beautifully, like flawlessly, but it genuinely soaks up a shit ton of product. That's the only thing, but it does make my skin look cute, so it's all right. Beauty blender, I'll let you off, you know what I mean. This color as well is so nice. It's got that nice yellow undertone, which I love to kind of match with my fake tan. Oh my hair. I love the finish as well. It definitely is luminous, like you can see the glow right now on my skin. I feel like it's struggling to cling onto my nose a teeny bit, like I'm not getting the coverage that I want, but that could be better with a brush. I have to say though, so far I'm really impressed with the way that this looks on my skin. It doesn't look heavy or like I've got a layer of foundation on my skin. You can still see my skin peeping through the foundation. It just looks really fresh. So far, I really like it. Now for some concealer. So again, this is another product that I have never used. This is their Born This Way Naturally Radiant Concealer. It says it's oil-free again. You know I'm about that oil-free life because I already have enough myself. I have two shades here. I have it in light, medium, and medium. Medium looks more like my skin tone and I kind of want a more brighter under eye, so I'm gonna go for light, medium. The packaging's cute. I feel like all the Too Faced packaging though is hella cute, right? Like, genuinely kills me. Like, deceased, 10 feet under, arranged my funeral. So let's get these triangles going on. It's actually a little bit thicker than I expected. I don't know why I thought it was gonna be hella thin, but not like thick, but I can feel kind of a bit of drag when I'm doing it. Do some highlighting. Kind of smells like coconut. Kind of smells like alcohol. Gonna use my beauty blender again. It's like my favorite way to blend out concealer. Just blending out easy. Like my arm is not having to do a workout. This is gonna sound so weird, but kind of to be expected because it's called the same thing. It genuinely reminds me of a concealer version of the foundation. Like, it's dewy like the foundation. I feel like it's got that medium slash buildable coverage to it, which I don't mind. I mean, personally, I like a full ass coverage concealer because I want it to cover all my insecurities, my problems, you know what I mean? I feel like personally, I would just like a teeny bit more coverage, but I have really bad dark circles. So let me put on like a teeny bit more. Sorry. It does just look really good on the skin. I have to say it's a really nice concealer. The only thing I wish is that I had a teeny bit more coverage, but apart from that, everything else about it, 10 out of 10. Right, let's set all this hard work in place. So I have two powders here. I have the powder to go along with the Born This Way range. This is the Born This Way Ethereal. Ethereal? It's their Lucent powder. I've actually used this before and I've used up a whole one, so that's probably saying something. So I might try this one because I've never used it before. This is the Primed and Poreless Skin Skin Smoothing Pressed Powder. Primes and Poreless primes before makeup, then sets foundation after without changing skin tone, which is fab. Provides a stunning soft focus effect for all skin tones, even under bright and unforgiving lights. The real question for me is, does this powder flash back? Anything that's normally skin smoothing, I get like hella scared that it's gonna like ghost me out. So you have the powder and then you have a little puff, a little baby puff. These things kind of gross me out a little bit. So I'm just gonna put you. Oh yeah, guys. Oh, that's really loud. All the brushes that I'm gonna be using in this video, again, are gonna be a first impressions. However, I have heard real good things about this brand. So these brushes you can get on Cult Beauty, which is fab. They actually have so many brushes, so many brands, it's so cool. But these ones are by Zoeva, which is a brand that I've heard many good things about. This is the complete set, 15 brushes and clutch. You heard me right, ladies and gents. And clutch. It's so classy, right? Like, you could legit use this as a clutch for a night out, or you could, you know, just put your makeup in it, whatever tickles your pickle. And then of course the main part, the brushes. Now what I love about this brush set, the one thing I always hate about brush sets normally is you never get good eye blending brushes. Like, they just don't exist. Like that fluffy crease brush, like, I don't know where she is. Whereas in this kit you actually get proper eye brushes. And I'm here for it. So you get 5 face brushes in this collection, and then you get 10 eye brushes too. It's so weird, I don't feel like I'm putting anything on my face right now. This is the 106 powder brush, by the way. Definitely has mattified though. Like, if you compare this side of my face to this side of my face, I'm not gonna sit underneath my eyes because I kind of wanna use the loose powder to bake, so I just skip that. But so yeah, I can't feel the powder on my skin, so it's really, really super finely milled. Poreless? I don't really know. I genuinely just feel like it's kind of like any powder to me. Like, it's not standing out like crazy. Right, let's do a flush test. Let's see if this flushes back. I can't tell whether my face just looks really pasty because I have no color on it, or whether that's like a flashback cast. My face doesn't have patches of like white. It just overall looks quite casty. So I mean, it's okay. It hasn't like blown my socks off or anything. I do think I prefer the loose powder from what I can remember. I'm just taking some of the loose powder actually just to bake underneath my eyes. I don't know why, I just prefer loose powder for underneath my eyes. I'm just gonna like leave this to bake. So I'm gonna look a little crazy for a minute. For bronzer, I'm gonna use a product that I have used before. This is their Dark Chocolate Soleil Longwear Matte Bronzer. This one is the dark chocolate one. The reason why this is my favorite one is because it's so warm. For bronzer in the brush set, there is this little one here, but I kind of wanna save this for blush. I feel like it's smaller and just would be better for blush. So I'm just gonna go back in with the same brush that I used for the powder. I'm pretty sure I used this bronzer in a first impressions And I actually ended up really liking it. It is quite red toned. I think this is made for more kind of like darker complexions. But hey, you know what? We break the rules around it. No, but it is true though. Makeup doesn't have any rules. So just wear whatever you feel comfortable with. Brush is so soft. Oh, it's doing a really, really good job at blending out my bronzer as well. I'm just gonna wipe this bake off. Why have I got one eye closed? I'm legit so weird when I do my makeup, honestly. Like, I don't know what I do half the time. Blush now, I'm gonna be using this palette here. Look at this. This is gorge. Just looks and feels so luxurious. Like, look at this. How freaking pretty is this packaging? This is another product that I have never tried. I'm pretty sure there's highlight, blushes, and bronzers. Oh my God. Look how like stunning they are. This highlight though. Oh my God. On a, oh, still got its protection on. On this Zoeva 128 cream cheek brush, I'm gonna take the color Pink Sand, which is this one at the bottom. I'm scared. First of all, this little brush is the perfect size for my cheek. And this color's cute as well. They have the perfect amount of pigment. Like, you don't go in, get a crap ton on your brush, put it on your face, and then ruin your entire look. You have time to like build it up, which is perfect for blush, because the worst thing is too pigmented blush. Like, it just, once you go in, you can't go back. She cute. Like, it's rosy and just giving me some color, like some life back into my skin. Yeah, cute. Cute, cute, cute. And I'm excited to try the rest of the colors in here, like this highlight here. On to the next. Now, normally when a highlight is good, people talk about it, right? And maybe I missed the hype on this, but I haven't heard that many people speak about this highlighter. So I really don't know what to expect. This is their Love Light Prismatic Highlighter. This one is in the color You Light Up My Life. Oh. High packaging. She cute or whatever. So this is the highlighter. It's super golden. Like, I hope it's not too golden. I think we'll be all right. Look at the pattern on this highlighter though. Look at that. So pretty. I feel like I'm just talking about packaging, jeez. The only brush I could kind of find for my highlighter is the 110 Face Shape brush. So I'm just gonna use this. Right, let's go in. Ooh. Okay, I see you. I'm gonna be real, this brush is not the best to use for highlighter, but I mean, it's going on there. The color is really pretty and it's got a really nice shine to it. I would say that the formula, look at that. It definitely has that more metallic shine to it rather than that wet look, which I'm not mad at. Ooh, this brush is good for the bridge of your nose. I mean, you can't say that I'm not glowing, right? I'm glowing. Okay, Too Faced. Skin so far, they know what they're doing. They know what they're talking about. Okay, so eye makeup. I don't really know what to do at this moment in time. I have an eyeshadow palette in front of me, some liner. We're just gonna roll with it. We're gonna go with the flow. So the palette I'm using today is the Natural Matte Eyeshadow Palette. So inside you have just a bunch of matte shades. I've kind of dabbled into this palette a couple times, but I haven't properly used it, you know, to create a full eye look. Not gonna lie though, like, these shades are right up my street. Oh, wait, where is it? I'm gonna prime my eyes first using their Shadow Insurance 24 Plus Hour Anti-Crease Eyeshadow Primer. So it's kind of like a nude color and it's actually quite thin. I was kind of expecting it to be a bit thicker and I don't know why. I'm just switching to this Zoeva Concealer Buffer Brush to blend it in, and it actually has concealed all the discoloration on my eyelids, which is always a must from me. It has to create like a really smooth and even base so that my eyeshadows can really pop and just make it easy for me to blend out, etc. Look at me talking like I know what I'm on about. Okay, Jordan. Right, now back to the palette. I'm just going to set my lids with the color Heaven. Now dipping into the color called Au Naturel on a 228 Luxe Crease Brush, which looks like a perfect fluffy kind of like blending crease brush. It actually is pretty pigmented, you know. Like, it's the kind of color that you wouldn't think would do much, but this one actually is. This brush as well is blending it out so nicely. Like, it's keeping the product concentrated, but it's buffing out the edges, if you know what I mean. It's good, it's good, it's good. Now taking a 231 Luxe Petite Crease. So it's the same brush but smaller, basically. The names in this palette, by the way, are so funny. Sexpert, Cleavage, Risky Biz. So cute, so cute. Oh, that is pigmented. I'm gonna put this in the crease too. Whoa. And then on that same brush, I'm gonna take the color Sexpert, which is like my favorite name in the palette, and just deepen that line up ever so slightly. I think I'm gonna do some sort of cut crease. Who knows? Because I don't. Do you know what? They seem to be blending out really, really nicely. Like, they don't look patchy or... Okay. I think I am gonna do the cut crease thing. So I'm gonna take the Born This Way concealer again. Just put a little bit on my hand. Take in this Luxe Smoky shader and the concealer. We're just gonna carve out the crease. I mean, I'm not really too sure what I'm doing. Well, if that's not the story of my life. I love how like dead silent it is right now. Holy guacamole, this brush is so good for a cut crease. I'm gonna take a mixture of Heaven and Lace Teddy and kind of set that in place. And then to fade the outer corner, I'm just gonna go back and forth between Hookup and Sexpert just to really deepen it and fade it in to the lid. Yeah, these eyeshadows blend out so nicely. Like the fade from the outer corner going in is really nice. So I am impressed. On this Soeva Brow Line brush, it's just like a really thin little guy. I'm just gonna take a little bit of Sexpert and just outline the cut crease here, just around it to get it really sharp. Just defines that line a little bit more, I guess. I don't know. Should we do a little wing? Should we do it? Should we go all out? So I'm definitely at least gonna line my upper lid just so when I stick on lashes, it looks okay. And obviously I've still got to clean up this, but the Sketch Marker Liquid Art Eyeliner. Inspired by Japanese calligraphy pens, our innovative formula was created to be exceptionally smooth, vivid, and waterproof. If I can actually get out. Actually made the packaging like a pen. Like they've given it that little hook of it here as well. Oh my God, that is so cute. Now, I never normally use pen eyeliners because I feel like they run out quite quickly, if you know what I mean, when you're using them. We don't judge over here. This could be the best eyeliner I've ever used in my life. The tip's nice and thin. Ooh, I like the tip. I can get right into the root of my lashes. It's super black as well, like jet black. I was gonna do a wing, but I don't know if I'm brave enough. I can already see what's gonna happen, okay? I'm gonna draw the wing and it's gonna get thicker and thicker to the point where I cover up all the eyeshadow I've done on my eye. Okay, so I've done one eye. Now we're gonna try and do the other. Wish me luck. It is time to put on some mascara and lashes because I'm feeling a little bit naked. For mascara, you can probably guess what I'm gonna use, the Better Than Sex mascara. Is it really better than the Sex? Totally up to you. But it is a freaking good mascara, so. I know that this mascara on Cult Beauty is a bestseller, so even just with that information, it's like, it's good. I feel like this is the mascara that people always repurchase. Like it's people's cults. Cults, Cult Beauty. Okay, Jordan, just stop. Oh, like look at this mascara on my lashes. To be completely honest, you could so just use this mascara and be done. But you know your gal is gonna put on some lashes. This mascara, every time I use it, I'm like, yes. Like this is what I want my lashes to look like. These are my real lashes. This is what this mascara does to my lashes. If you are looking for a new mascara and you've never tried this one, you need to. Right, let's stick on some lashes real quick. While my lash glue is drying, I'm just taking Hookup underneath my eye, and then I'm just gonna blend that out with Au Naturel. Just to really finish off the eye makeup, you know, bring everything together. Lashes are on. Ugh, I feel like the eye makeup is actually complete now. Real quick, I feel like I want the bottom lash to be a bit more smokier, so I'm just gonna take a random brown little Kohl pencil and just pop it into my waterline. Lining your waterline is the weirdest feeling ever. It actually looks the weirdest thing ever. Finally, we're on to the last part of this testing video, which is the lips. So I have a few things here to try. I have some of their Melted Matte Liquid Lipsticks, which I have used before. Do really enjoy these. I have some of their newer, I'm not sure what they're called, but they look like this. They're like regular lipsticks and the packaging. Look at this. Look. Too Faced just know how to do packaging, like it's official. And there's like a bunch of nude colors and sort of dark browns and stuff, which I think is so nice. I also have one of their Melted Liquified Longwear lipsticks as well here. I don't really know what to use. Do you know what? I think I'm gonna use one of their Melted Matte Liquified Matte Lipstick things. This one here is the color Cool Girl, which I feel like will go quite nicely. And then I might put one of their Melted Liquified Longwear lipsticks on top. We'll see. you know, I can't really remember what I thought of these liquid lipsticks. I don't think they were overly drying at all because I used to wear the absolute crap out of these. I really like the way they apply though because they're not overly thick, so you don't feel like you've got, you know, something on your lips, but they're not really super thin that they don't have any color to them. They're nice. They're nice. I like them. So I'm going to take the melted lipstick. So I don't think this is matte. I think it's just like a melted lipstick. This is in the color Sugar. Oh, that smells like sweets. The color is pretty. I actually really like the applicator as well, like the sponge tip. I feel like I can blend the color out. They feel nice too, like they're not sticky in the slightest. It feels quite like thin as well, like when you rub your lips together. Hmm. Anyway, to finish off, of course, I'm going to spray some setting spray. This is the Hangover 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray. Silicone-free, alcohol-free, oil-free, just free of everything. This is a product that's not new to me. It smells amazing and, like, it feels really good on my skin. Okay, so this full face of Too Faced makeup is complete. Let's just talk about my final thoughts. I am, like, a little bit shook. I mean, I know I've always loved the majority of the Too Faced makeup I've tried, but all the stuff I tried today, there was nothing that I literally hated and will never use again. I will for sure be using this makeup again, like without a doubt. And I think it's so rad that Cult Beauty stock all of this makeup. All of the makeup I used on my face today, you can get at Cult Beauty, which is so good. And they have so much as well. It's not like they've just picked out like 5 things from the brand. They have a full face of makeup. Like they have a crap ton of stuff from the brand. So for all my gals and boys that love, you know, a little bit of Too Faced, Cult Beauty have it for you. I'm super happy with the way this video turned out and I really hope you guys enjoyed it and hopefully have some products in mind that you want to maybe purchase for yourself. Don't forget all of the discounts that Cult Beauty have at the moment for Too Faced and also my discount code. I will leave everything in the description box below, so check that out. Like, don't miss out, guys. If you can save some coins or get some free products, make the most of it. Anyway, that is all from me. A huge thank you to Cult Beauty for working with me on this video. I love you guys, so it's been fun. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button, and also if you want to see a little bit more of me and you want to stick around, then don't forget to subscribe before you go. And also click that notification bell so you don't miss an upload from me. Oh my god, I sound like such a YouTuber. Thank you guys so, so much for taking the time to watch this video. I love every single one of you so, so much. And I will see you all in my next one. Mwah. Bye. Oh, this face is... It's like a natural... Well, actually, Oh, it smells good too.
Oh god, got it.
Yeah, I've been bad gal. Chung Lee. Everything around me.